Steven is a silhouette of what he used to be. He was like the heroes on the movie screen. Then something happened when he lost his family. A little bit of him died. Now he's just one man in a king-size bed. Sold a minivan for a new Corvette. He keeps seeing people in the corner of his eye. What do you want from me? Why are you taunting me? Is it God or the devil that is haunting me? Why is it so hard to tell if you wish me well or harvesting my soul to drag me down to hell? I'm indifferent. I like me better when I don't listen. Sarah's partner lived life full throttle. Sarah's partner had a problem with the bottle. But on the weekend he would lead a congregation. And Sarah didn't want to ruin all their faith, so she kept the facade of slept with a monster. He'd repent in the process, she'd tell he was honest. She'd run to the mall and go spend all their dollars. She'd empty their coffers, not a penny for vodka. Shadow at the shops followed her home. Freedom feeling that the Pharisee had no hope. Cause manipulative men don't relinquish control when they haven't been a loyal followers by their throat. But Sarah felt she was called by God to save him. The only person who had half the heart to change him. While they provided eyes for his lies, she would cry of her heart in the night. What do you want from me? Why are you taunting me? Is it God or the devil that is haunting me? Why is it so hard to tell if you wish me well or harvesting my soul to drag me down to hell? I'm different. I like me better when I don't listen. What are these things you say? Is it a test of faith? Or am I confusing grandiosity with grace? Am I delusional to want to change the world? What's the point if it's eroding all of my self-worth? I'm indifferent. I like me better when I don't listen.